Hello learners, today we are learning about referencing styles. If you are writing a paper, thesis, project report or an article, generally you go for literature survey. You tend to borrow some ideas. You copy the words, phrases, sentences or paragraphs from different works. This is called referencing. Referencing means recording of all the bibliographic details of a particular work. This is done to show your readers what you have studied from different papers or books or dissertations or project reports.
An investigator or a researcher, he refers to different types of material while doing his research. Like he consults textbooks, monographs, and he may consult different types of journal articles and encyclopedias and print, non-print material and also electronic sources. So a researcher is often confused about the various terms like reference, bibliography and citations. A reference is a generic term which is used in the sense that it gives a direction to the reader to find a particular source of information. This information includes the author of the book, the title and different bibliographic elements as well as the pagination. The reader can go to that particular source and refer to the information. A bibliography is attached at the end of the dissertation. So, bibliography is also a list of sources which the investigator uses or refers or consults during the process of investigation. The other term, citations, is used to is also a list of books which the researcher actually cites in the text. So, like this you can differentiate these different terms which are used for referencing in a research report.
What is the need for referencing? To acknowledge the words, ideas or phrases or summaries or abstracts of the different authors, previous authors, you have to cite them. Then you have to respect the authors who have given those ideas or the material for you. So that it is avoids a sort of plagiarism. So you are respecting the previous authors' works and you are citing them.
And also the researcher, through the references, he gives an idea of further research also. And also this the reader who is reading the dissertation of the thesis, he will get a chance to verify the facts that the investigator has mentioned in the text. And also the dissertation or the research paper attains a scholarly stature if the references are enclosed within the thesis. These are the various reasons for providing references during a research investigation.
Then what are the material you cite? So they are print material, non-print material, electronic material. Print material like books, journal articles, newspaper items, thesis, dissertations, all are the print material, and also grey literature also you have to cite. In the case of non-print material, the audiovisual material, then microforms, cartography material, these are the non-print material. Then you have the electronic databases and the emails and websites. These are the electronic material generally you cite.
Then, what are the elements which we usually include while giving a reference? So, the first element is the author, the name of the author, and then followed by the year of publication. And then the other elements are place of publication, name of the publisher, and pagination is very important. And apart from this, if the referring material is a journal, then the volume number, issue number and pagination. So, like this, the elements all, there is slight variation in the type of elements which are included in the references.
There is a standard pattern of sequencing these elements. So, first you have to see, as per the style guides, you have to go for the author's name, generally the date, then the title, then the place of publication, publisher, then pagination. This is the standard sequence followed by different guides, but there is some variation among these sequences according to different guides. So, then you have to think about the typefaces, the normal typeface or italics or underline. These are the things as given by the different style guide publishers you have to follow.
And there are many style guides which the researcher can follow while preparing the references. Several universities provide their own style guides, but the most famous or most popular and widely used style guides, I will just give you a mention. The first and foremost is APA style guide. APA stands for American Psychological Association. This style guide is published in the year 2001 by the American Psychological Association in Washington. This style guide is mostly used by the social science researchers for providing the references. And then the next style guide is MLA style guide. Here, MLA stands for Modern Language Association. This style guide is prepared by the Modern Language Association in the year 1998, and the second edition is now currently available, and then this is published from New York. And this style guide, it is mainly used by the researchers of literature humanities.
Harvard System of Referencing Guide is mainly used in United Kingdom. Then International Standards Organization ISO 690-2, this is mainly used for information and documentation and providing bibliographic references. There are other several style guides also available. I will list out this. You can see the ACS style guide, third edition, published from New York, Oxford University Press, published in 2006. Then CBE citation guide. CBE means Council of Biological Editors. This is a sixth edition, published by Cambridge University Press, Cambridge, 1994. Then Chicago style guide. This is used mainly for the humanities. Then AGPS referencing. AGPS means Australian Government Publishing Service, 6th edition, published in 2002. Vancouver referencing. This is published in 2003. Then Oxford style. This is published by Oxford University Press in 2002. Then Turabian style. This is published by University of Chicago Press in 1996. The Columbia Guide to Online Style, published in 1998. And also you can refer to any standard journal and you can follow the style of referencing from them. In your works, you have to follow certain style, either any of these guides or so any standard periodical style. You know, from the Indian point of view, the Indian Standards Institution has also prepared a style guide like that, based on classified catalog code under Ranganathan's, Dr. S. R. Ranganathan. Style manuals or style guides provide list of rules on layout and font as well as referencing. These style guides are updated regularly. Nowadays, you find online guides and tutorials for providing references.
In addition to the references or bibliography or citations which are provided at the end of the dissertation, sometimes the researcher also can use endnotes and footnotes. Endnotes and footnotes, they are given at the end of the page or at the end of the chapter, and the reference number, it is given in the text. So, there are two systems for providing this, two different ways of providing the endnotes and footnotes. author date system and number system. In the author date system, the reference it gives the name of the author. In the number system, in the text, whatever number is given in the text, the numeric 1, 2 or 3, whatever is used in the text, the same number is used for the reference also. These are called endnotes and footnotes. The researcher has to be very careful while providing the endnotes and footnotes because they may sometimes interrupt the flow of the text. So, if the text is lengthy, because it may interrupt the flow of the text, the researcher has to be very, very careful while providing the endnotes and footnotes.
You also find abbreviations like IBID or IBIDM and also OPSIT. IBID or IBIDM means the same reference as above. Same reference can be taken as above. And OPSIT, the reference already cited in the sequence of the references, that is called OPSIT. So, these two abbreviations, IBID and OPSIT, are used in order to avoid the duplication of same references in the sequence of the references or citations you are providing in a bibliography.
This IBID and OPSIT, they are used for referring the endnotes or footnotes only, not for the references or bibliography. Usually, they are used for endnotes and footnotes. The OPSIT stands for Opus Citatum in Latin. So, whereas the IBID is used to refer the references that are used consecutively, just one after the other. It means like ditto mark, like it serves the purpose of ditto marks. Whereas OPSIT, it mentions the reader has to search the author which has been used in the previous reference. Now, we will examine the different punctuation marks which are used for preparing references for different types of materials like print, non-print and electronic sources using the APA style guide and MLA style guide. Format for referencing print materials. First is textbooks and monographs. First, we will take the simple example of books written by single author. We'll see what are the guidelines provided in the APA style guide. In the slide, you can see the first element is author, and this author field is followed by the year of publication in circular brackets. And then the next comes the title, which is given in italics. After the title, the place of publication, and then followed by the publisher, name of the publisher.
Books written by single author, MLA style. See the example. The author's name followed by title of the work, underlined. The place of publication, then the publisher's name, then the year of publication.
Next, we will take an example of books written by two authors according to the APA style. In this slide, in this example, you can see that there are two authors. The two authors should be listed and which are joined using the sign ampersand. And the name of the second author, it is followed by the year of publication within circular brackets. And this field, it is followed by the title.
Books written by two authors, first author and the second author, in between the and word is connecting them. Then title of the work, underlined. The place of publication, publisher's name and the year. Before publisher's name, there is a colon, and before the year, there is a comma.
Books written by more than three authors according to the APA style. Here, we list all the authors by their last names, and each author is separated from the other author by a comma. And then before the last, we use the sign punctuation ampersand, and followed by the date within circular brackets. Then this field is followed by the title.
Books written by more than three authors, MLA style. You see the first author's name, then et al., then title of the book, underlined, then place of publication, then publishers, then year of publication.
In case of a book produced under the editorial direction, in APA style, we have to list the name of the author followed by the abbreviation ED, then the year of publication, and then the title in italics followed by the place of publication and name of the publisher is preceded by a colon. And chapter in edited book, according to APA style, we have to list the name of the editor and then the name of the title of the work, and then in which volume this work is published. Then we have to use the letters IN in and the followed by the title of the work.
Format for referencing books with editor. In this example, you see the editor's name first. After the name, you find the abbreviation ED. Then title of the work underlined, then the place of publication, publisher's name, then the year of publication.
There are several works which are produced under the corporate authorship. Then in for such cases, according to AP style guide, first we have to enter the name of the corporate body. In the example which is shown in the slide, it is National Institute of Mental Health. It is the corporate body, which is followed by the date of publication enclosed in circular brackets. And then the title of the work is given in italics, followed by the place of publication and the name of the publisher.
Format for referencing corporate author, MLA style. In this example, you see the corporate body, American Medical Association, followed by the title of the work, that is the American Medical Association Encyclopedia of Medicine, edited, abbreviation ED is used for the editor, Charles B. Clayman, then place of publication, publisher, and the year of publication.
Now, we will see how to prepare references for a journal article according to the APA style. Here, in the example shown, there are three authors, and before the last author, the ampersand sign is prefixed, and then after the author statement, the year of publication is given in circular brackets, and this field follows the title of the work, which is followed by the name of the journal, Journal of Agricultural Education. The name of the journal is followed by volume number, volume is 44 volume, and the issue number is given within circular brackets, and then followed by the pagination. Pagination is preceded by the punctuation comma.
Format for referencing journal article, MLA style. In this example, you find author's name rendered as in cataloging, Hans Patrick. Then the title of the work is given in quotation mark. Then title of the journal, that is underlined, the volume number, and the year of publication is given in parentheses, then colon, then the pagination.
Now, format for referencing of non-print materials. Firstly, electronic sources. In the first example, format for referencing e-books according to APA style. In the example shown, first there is an author, the name of the author is rendered, followed by the title of the work and website address from which this work has been retrieved is given.
Formatting for referencing electronic books, MLA style. See the example. The author's name is given first, then the title is underlined, then editor's name, a test name is preceded by ED, then year of publication, then the website.
Format for referencing online scholarly journal according to the APA style. If you see the example, there are two authors here. This is the citation order we have given. There can be single author or two authors or more than three authors also. So, the rules are same as mentioned previously, and the author name is followed by the date of publication in circular brackets, and then this field is followed by the title of the article, and then this is followed by title of the journal, volume number, and then there will be a digital object identifier for the online scholarly journal. That number you have to give it in the after the volume number in case of online scholarly journals.
Format for referencing online scholarly journal MLA style. The author's names are given here. In this case, there are two authors, the first author's name and then second author's name. Then the title of the article, that is given in quotation marks. Then the name of the journal, name of the journal is underlined, then volume number, then in parentheses you see the year of publication, then pagination, then from which site it is retrieved, educause, then the date on which the article is retrieved, and website address is given there.
In this lesson, we have seen how to prepare references while writing a research report. We have discussed the different concepts like reference, bibliography, citations, and we have seen what is the need for providing the references, and then we have discussed the different style guides like APA style guide, MLA style guide, and along with examples for print, non-print and electronic sources.
మా ఈ కార్యక్రమాలపై మీ అభిప్రాయాల్ని, సూచనల్ని, సలహాల్ని ఆహ్వానిస్తున్నాం. మా చిరునామా ద డైరెక్టర్, ఆడియో విజువల్ ప్రొడక్షన్ అండ్ రీసెర్చ్ సెంటర్, డాక్టర్ బిఆర్ అంబేద్కర్ ఓపెన్ యూనివర్సిటీ, రోడ్ నంబర్ 46, జూబ్లీ హిల్స్, హైదరాబాద్, 500033.